What is up, guys? Today we're going to be discussing the Samsung Galaxy A52 versus the new A22 5G. So the standard A52 is really hard to find. So you can find the 5G one for $400, but this one I got for $300. But they're, like I said, they're super hard to find now. So the 5G one, the only difference is it's got 120Hz and a slightly faster chipset. This one has just the 90Hz. So on the A22 5G, this one costs $236, and then depending on which configuration you want, it'll cost a little under $300. So I think that the pricing is kind of awkward depending on what variant you get. But let's go ahead and get started, because you may want an A52, you may want the little bells and whistles and pay the extra money, or you may just be satisfied with the A22. Alright, so I need to start off with the displays here, because this is actually one of the biggest differences here. So on the A22, it's a TFT 90Hz display at 6.6 inches. It's 1080p, 399 for the PPI. The A52 has a Super AMOLED 90Hz display, 1080p, and that one is 407 for the PPI. As you can see, punch hole on the A52, which I love, and then you have a wider drop notch on the A22. So as far as display, the A52 has a much, much better display, and it's actually much brighter and way more colorful. So that is the benefit of having a Super AMOLED display. So that is something to consider. You also have significantly less bezel on the A52 as well. But as you can see, you know, the A22 is slightly bigger, so if you want a bigger phone, that's also something to consider. But as far as display quality, I think I'm easily going with the A52 here. If you're somebody that watches a lot of video, then I would save the money up and get the A52 all day, because you know, you're just not gonna get this screen is not as bright as the A52, so you have a way easier time viewing this one outdoors as well. But they actually both have that 90Hz silky smoothness, which is something that I love. So that is really awesome for both of these devices. I just love that these budget phones are now pretty much standard with 90Hz now. So that is pretty cool. All right, guys, I want to check out the Geekbench scores here and explain something. So pretty interesting scores here. So with the standard A52, you can see it loses in the single and multi-core score to the A22 5G. And if it looks like this is super dim, I have it turned all the way up. This is the viewing angle thing. So if I do it like that, you can see it looks brighter. That's what people say when a phone has good viewing angles. So this TFT display, again, not as good as a Super AMOLED. But let me keep explaining this. So they're both running Android 11, One UI 3.1. Now, on the A22, we have the MediaTek chip. It's the 700 5G Mali G57. On this model, it's 128 gigs of storage and 6 gigs of RAM with micro SD support. The A52 does have the Snapdragon 720G and then the Adreno 618 micro SD support, 128 gigs of internal storage and 6 gigs of RAM. But the A22 does slightly beat it out in this score. So let's go ahead and launch some applications. Let's try Instagram. A52 actually got it there. And this is why you guys see I like to do real world tests and not so much the benchmarks. A52. A52 again. So you can see, even though we got a score difference, the A52 is still overall going to be faster. It looks like when launching applications in the real world. So as you can see, you know, a big difference here. Now, I do want to talk about hardware. So these are two beautiful phones on here. Look at these two phones. I love the way Samsung is going this year with their smartphones. I mean, these are two very nice looking devices, guys. So I just absolutely love it. Now, they're both plastic phones all the way. So there's, I know that looks like metal, but it's actually not. Both plastic phones, they both have a nice weight to them. And I think they both look great. for the price that you're paying. Now, there is something to note. The A52 does have an IP67 dust and water resistant. So if you drop this phone on the toilet or something like that, this will not break. This one has no IP rating. So do note that. Now, also on the A52 or the A22, we have our power button with the fingerprint scanner, which I absolutely love. I think it's much better than the in-display one on the A52 here. It's just not as fast, even though I've never had like an actual issue with it. And you do have face unlock on both of these phones as well. It's just not as fast as, like, you know, the physical method. It's just super smooth, so it never misses a beat with that one. So both these phones, you do have a headphone jack down below, USB Type-C. The A52 does have stereo speakers as well. There are no stereo speakers on the A22 5G as well, so do note that. Just so you can hear the difference side by side, I'll go ahead and play them out max volume. Now you see, if I accidentally cover the speaker up, or if I just sort of like cup it up a little bit, you see how much sound I'm losing? That's why I always advocate for stereo speakers. So overall, obviously, you're gonna get a fuller and louder sound on the A52. All right, so for my gamers here, let's check out our PUBG graphics here, see what we get. So on the A52, we can go ultra smooth, ultra balance, and then high HD, and that's it. On the let's just get into this one. The A22 here, we have ultra, ultra HD. So we pretty much have the same graphics on both of these phones. So as far as your PUBG and overall gaming performance, again, if you're a casual gamer, it's gonna be fairly solid on both of these phones. Like I said, if I was gonna choose out of the two, I would still go with the A52 for gaming because the display is much better. Colors and everything just look better. The display is a little bit more immersive with the punch hole. But as you can see, A22 still has a decent display. It is a little bit bigger, but again, I think I would still prefer just the display as far as like graphic power. You know, they're both going to be pretty much on par with each other here. All right, so let's check out our toggles here. So on the A52, we got screen recording. We also have our NFC toggle in secure folders, Samsung Kids, and we are missing a few. So we have no secure folders on the A22. No NFC. This device does not have NFC. We also do not have screen recording on here. Let me make sure. Yeah, we don't have it on here. So you are missing those toggles as well. So also do note that. Now, image quality is pretty good on both of these phones. Like I said, for the price, I was super impressed with the A52, but I was also more impressed with the A22 for that $200 price point. If you get just the entry level one, that is some very good cameras in the $200 price range. But let me start off with the A52 here. So we have a quad camera setup, a 64 megapixel standard, 12 megapixel ultra wide, 5 megapixel macro, and depth sensor. Obviously, the A52 is going to be the better camera out of the two. It just takes overall better photos in every, you know, aspect as far as detail, the ultra wide being better. Just everything about the A52's cameras are better. You also have a 32 megapixel selfie that also shoots in 4K as well. And as you can see from these shots, very good camera on the A52. That was one of the things I was extremely impressed with when I first got this phone. You're getting some really, really nice cameras on this phone. So also the A22. The A22 also still impressed me. I'm super impressed with Samsung's image quality on their budget phones this year. So this one has a triple camera setup, so you do not have a quad camera setup like the A52 here, and you are missing the macro lens on the A22. So, you know, you're missing that. But you have a 48 megapixel standard, 5 megapixel ultra wide, 2 megapixel depth sensor, and then you get a strange resolution of 1152p 30fps, and then the selfie is 8 megapixels, shoots in 1080p, and the A52 shoots in 4K. So overall, you know, obviously you're paying more, so you're going to get more. But as you can see, A22's photos look really good at this budget price point. So I'm not going to say anything negative. I think it takes great photos, color-wise, detail, the ultra-wide. I just think it does a really good job. Alright, so on the A22, you do have a 5,000 milliamp battery on here, as opposed to the 4,500 milliamp battery on the A52. So you will get overall better battery life on the A22, not by much, but you will get, you know, overall better screen on time here. So overall, I'm super impressed with both of these phones. I think if you just need the sort of like the bare minimum, I think you still get a lot with the A22, but if you don't want to spend over $300, I definitely think this is a great buy. But if you need the extra bells and whistles, like the stereo speakers, slightly better cameras, the better display, then I would definitely get the A52 here. It just comes down to your personal needs. As far as performance, like I said, the The A52 is slightly faster opening apps, but as far as your gaming performance, they're pretty much on par. So, all right, that's pretty much it. Thanks for watching, and I'll catch you guys in the next one.